greetings all. I hope you all are fine. So today we are starting with a new chapter, that is chapter number 4, basic geometrical ideas. Okay, the name itself is, here we read geometrical. What do you mean by geometry? That is some shapes we will study here. So sabse first of all I will tell you what is a point. Basically a point that determines a direction. Okay, we don't know about this. If this is a point, we can go here, we can go here, we can go here. So point is something which tells you direction. Okay, next we are coming to a line segment. What is a line segment? It is the shortest distance between the two points. Suppose this is a point A, point is a B. So this line segment, this is a line segment AB. This will just a shortest distance between the two points, that is point A and point B. Next we are coming to a line. Beta, what is a line? A line is an extension. These are just two line segments. A line is an extension of these line segment. We don't know where we are going. It is just an extension of a line segment. Okay. Now we are coming to what is a ray. Basically a ray whose fixed point, this is a fixed point. It can go in any direction like this. Okay, this OC is a ray. Okay everyone, so in this way there are two types of, what is a curve? Basically a curve can be drawn like this using free hands. Okay, we can draw any curve, but a smooth curve, that is a simple curve, will not trace itself. It means it will not come this way. There are two types of curves, closed curve and open curve. I will tell you in the next exercise of this. So now we are proceeding to the exercise 4.1. Okay everyone. What's there in the exercise 4.1? I will tell you now. Exercise 4.1. There is a figure in the question number 1 given like this. You know, here in first part they are saying how many points are there. So you can see O, B, C, D, E. There are 5 points, O, B, C, D, E. These are points. Okay, I am writing points as PTS. Now in the second part they are saying what is a line. A line, I already told you, it is an extension of line segment. You can see this line segment is extended OC like this. So this BD is a line. Now we are coming to a ray. A ray which has a fixed point like this. OC, OB, OE, OD. These are many rays. And in the fourth part we have line segments. Okay, now we are talking about line segment, that is the shortest distance, you know, a line segment. A line segment, you can see this DE. This is a line segment. EO, this is again a line segment. BOC, this is again a line segment. This BE is again a line segment. Okay everyone. But you can't say this OE because it is extended like this. So I'm writing EO or OE, it's your choice. So now we are coming to the question number 2 now. I think question number 1 is clear to all of you. So we are proceeding to the next question now. What is there in the question number 2? I will explain it. Now what's there in the question number 2? I will explain. This is a line A, B, C, D. Here we have to tell how many lines, 12 possible, basically how many lines possible. We will just fix one point and vary all the points like this. AB is a line. We can just put this is just representing a line. AB, AC, then we have AD. Again when we fix B, so BC, BD,
then BA. Again, when we fix C point CD, we are going to D, then CBCA. CA, CB. We are fixing one point and varying other. Next, we have D, DA, DB, and DC. So, I think this is clear to all of you. These are the remaining 12 lines we have explained here. Now, we are coming to question number 3. Here, they have given a figure. Okay. This is a figure there in the question. That is, this is a point A. This is just a line. This is a point C. This is a point B. This is a point D. And below here, like this, this is a point E. And this is a point F. Now here, we have to tell the line containing point E. You know the line containing point E is a line AE. This is a point A. Line AE. Now what's there in the second part? That is a line passing through A. A line passing through A is AE. Obviously it is AE. Next we have in the third part, the line on which point O lies. Where is the point O? O is the point here. Line OC. On line OC, this point O lie. Next we have two pairs of intersecting lines. Beta, here you can see these are intersecting lines. AE and OC. AE, OC. And others are AE, EF. Okay? I think this is clear to all of you. This question number 3. So we are moving forward to the question number 4 now. What is there in the question number 4? I will tell you. Question number 4, that is, from one point how many lines can be drawn? Infinitely many lines. From one point we can draw infinitely many lines. From second part, if you have two points, how many lines? Only one line. This is your unique line, okay? Now we are coming to question number 5 now. We have to draw a line segment containing P on this line. This is a point, this is a AB line containing P point. We have to draw now two lines which is intersecting at one point. We can draw it like this. There are two lines. We can suppose it like XY. This is point PQ. They are intersecting at a common vertex, that is M you can take. Now in the third part we have to draw a line L with points E and F such that a point D lie outside. You can draw it outside this. Okay everyone. So, I think this is clear to all of you. Question number 4 is also the same. You can see. Now, we are coming to the next exercise. Okay, everyone. What's there in the next exercise? We will see. Exercise 4.2. What is there in exercise 4.2? You all know it's based on open curve and closed curve. You know open curves that it will not repeat on itself. Suppose exercise 4.2 question number 1. This is a Z. Okay. Its first part is this Z. This is open or closed. Obviously it is open because its starting point is this and ending point is this. It is not overlapping. So what's there in the second part? This is somewhat like a figure is given. You know it's repeating, so it is a closed curve. Now in the third part we have somewhat like that. This is open. You can see the starting point is this, ending point is this. Now we are coming to its fourth part. This is a triangle. This is a closed curve or open curve? Obviously closed curve. Next we have to draw any closed curve. This is given like somewhat like this. This is closed or open. Yes, it is closed. You can see when we start from this point, this will overlap like this and this will come to this point. Okay, so this is a closed curve. Now in question number 2, in first part, we have to draw an open curve. We can draw any open curve. like this. This is an open curve. In the second part, we have to draw any closed curve. This is a closed curve, we can say. Now in the third part, what they are saying, we have to just draw a closed curve and draw shade its interior. You can shade its interior. This is, I have shaded the interior portion. Okay, everyone. So now we are coming to the fourth part. They are saying this is a figure given in the question. Like this. They are saying, is it a curve or not? Yes, it is a curve. Because we can draw it like this. Yes, it is a curve. Okay, everyone. So we are coming to the next question, the last question of this exercise. What's there in this exercise? You can tell me. This is question number 3. They are saying we have to draw a closed curve but not polygon. Okay. What are polygons? Polygons made up of at least 3 line segments. Okay. More than 3 minimum number of line segments, that is straight lines, must be 3. So you know this circle is a closed curve but it is not a polygon. Why? Because it is not made up of any line segment. So what's there in the second part? A closed curve made up of entirely line segment. We can draw any closed curve, any open curve which is made up of, and this is open curve made up of line segments. I think this is clear to all of you. So now we are coming to the last third part. A polygon with 2 sides. A polygon with 2 sides. Actually, a polygon with 2 sides is not possible. Not possible. Why? Because a polygon must have minimum 3 number of sides. That is 3 line segments. So I think this exercise is clear to all of you.